सदाशिव समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानालय करुणालय नमा भगवत्द शंकर लोकशंकर शंकर शंकराचार्य केशवं बादरायण सूत्र भाष्यकृत वंदे भगवंत पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमव्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओं सहनावतु सहनौ नक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ब्रह्मविधातुमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिकसंसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। So we are looking at the Vilakshanatvadikaranam. So here we looked at the Sankhya Paksha, where Sankhya is making an Aropa which is actually applicable to his Paksha also. So he is saying Nar Vilakshanatvad Asya Tathatvam Cha Shabdat, or अभिमानी व्यपदेशस्तु विशेष अनुगतिभ्याम। एंड देन आफ्टर दिस पूर्वपक्ष एज टू द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कारण एंड कार्य इन द केस ऑफ द वेदांतिन सेज द पूर्वपक्षी सांख्य इज चैतन्य एंड जड़ा। यू हैव चैतन्य इज कारण एंड अचेतन, चेतन कारण एंड अचेतन कार्य। दिस काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग इज नॉट पॉसिबल। To that the answer was given, drishyate tu. Such examples are seen. You see such examples in loka also, as to the hair is born from a human being who is, or any being, living being. So living sentient being causes the insentient hair to grow out of him. Therefore such examples are seen. From a jada prithvi, the you see, I mean, what you see from the jada prithvi, the tree which is sentient is born. Therefore such examples are there in the loka. It cannot be an aropa. Such answer was given. Then asaditi chenna pratisheda matratvat. So the asat, if you say that chetana, which is namarupadi heena, and if you keep on doing negation there, as the Shruti says that the Karya is born out of this Chetana, and then Karya has Nama Rupa, Chetana has no Nama Rupa. So when you say Karana has no Nama Rupa, while being in the Jagat, looking at the Jagat which is Karya, which has Nama Rupa, if you negate the Nama Rupa, then Asat, you may land on Shunyavada, Asat. To that the answer was given as to the Pratisheda is done. Only Pratisheda, that Asat, it is not Asat. That's what it means there. The Karana is not Asat. So such examples from various Upanishads where there can be confusion as to the Karana itself is Asat. That Nisheda is done. So we had seen an example where the Vakya level the Nanj works, not at the Shabda level. Then Apitav Tadvat Prasangad Asamanjasam. There is an Akshepa as to if at all the Shuddhatvadi Gunakam Brahma Jagad Upadanam, if the Upadana Karana has Shuddhatvadi Gunas, Shuddha Guna. So your Brahma is Shuddha Brahma, which has become Karana for Jagat. Then what will happen? Pralaya Samaye Tadvat Karyavat. Karya is Ashuddha. Nama Rupadi being there in the Karya, Karya is Ashuddha. Jagat is Ashuddha. And in this Shuddha Brahma, the Ashuddha Jagat will have Pralaya Kalpante. Then what will happen? The Shuddha Brahma will be tainted by the Ashuddha Karyas Gunas. to that the akshepa, the response was given as to natu drishtanta bhavat. So there is a drishtanta that the karana, where there is a karya laya, that karana does not get tainted by the karya's guna. So ghata, ghata becoming ghatadikam karyam rudi liyamanam sat. So the karya ghatadi getting powdered into the clay, which is its cause, does not taint the clay at all. Na dushayati swadharmena na dushayati. So such examples are there. Therefore, in the exemplified, the aropa cannot be made. Then, having responded to all the aropas of the Purvapakshi, the Siddhanti says, actually all these aropas that you have made, they are applicable to your paksha also. So swapaksha doshaccha, sankhyas will also have the same issue. Whatever issues you have pointed out as possible in Vedanta paksha, that is possible in your own paksha. Because your pradhana is also what? It is not having any parts, but the sattva, rajas, tamas gunas which are there, which is the swarupa of pradhana, into which there is a laya of the prapancha. The prapancha is manifold, and that kind of a prapancha will end up tainting your pradhana also. So how do you raise such an objection? Why do you raise such an objection towards a Vedanti when that is your own dosha also first? And then when the Purvapakshi accepts, the Siddhanti says that vastutaha prapancha satyatva vadinaha sankhyasya eva ete doshaha name anirvachaniya vadinaha iti bhavaha. Sankhyavada is parinamavada, prapancha is satya, and it is a parinama of pradhana. That being the case, the satya gunas of the prapancha will taint the pradhana, which has undergone parinama also, and where there is laya also. So all these doshas, where the karya gunas and karya itself is sat, has a satta, karya has the same level of satta that the karana has. In that case, only such doshas are possible, but anirvachaniya vadi Vedanti cannot have such doshas at all. So having hypothetically accepted that doshas which are pointed out, if at all they are there, we'll resolve it. And having resolved them, the Siddhanti finally says that these are applicable to your paksha in reality, and you have no answer to be given there, because the doshas or the gunas are real in the karya. In our case, they are not real because the karya itself is not real, let alone the gunas. Therefore, we don't have such an issue. Itascha. So now continuing from there, I think we had covered the 10th sutra. The 11th sutra is introduced in the vritti as itascha na kevalena tarkena samanvayo virudhyata ityaha. And due to this following reason also, kevalena tarkena, just by using tarka, tarka is anumana pramana. So anumana pramana alone cannot lead to any kind of a dosha in samanvaya that the Vedanti has established in the first adhyaya and in the first pada of the second adhyaya also, by extension, by refuting the objections raised, the samanvaya was established. Now here, tarka, which is anumana, loosely saying, it's an anumana, and anumana is a pramana. It is a pramana for Vedanta also, meaning not only in the laukika vakya analysis, but in the Vedanta vakya analysis also, tarka is a anumana is used. For tatparya nishchaya, anumana is used, because yukti is there as a as one of the Shadlingas. And then Manana itself has been stated by the Upanishad as sadhana for Aikya, for moksha. Therefore, Anumana Tarka is part of moksha sadhana also. That being the case, how can you say that Samanvaya, which is opposed by Tarka, still is not compromised? To that, the Siddhanti is saying that your Tarka is Kevala Tarka. What kind of a Tarka is Pramana for a Vedantin in the case of Brahmajnana? That Manana is a sadhana for Brahmajnana is acceptable to Vedanti, and that Manana is Tarka Rupa is also acceptable. The issue is, it is not Kevala Tarka Rupa. You cannot have Tarka which is not based on, meaning Manana which is not based on Shravana. So Shravana is of the Shruti. So Shruti based Manana should be done, Shruti based Tarka should be used, not Kevala Tarka. So an independent Tarka which does not have its foundation in Shruti is not a Pramana. And what you have been doing, you Sankhyas and Tarkikas, you have been using Shuddha Tarka, whereby your conclusions cannot be traced to Shruti at all. In fact, there is a Virodha with Shruti. Therefore, our Samanvaya, which is established by using Shruti as basis, cannot be compromised at all by Kevala Tarka. So, itascha na kevalena tarkena samanvaya viruddhyate ityaha. And it is going to be proven with other sutras. Tarka pratishthanadapyanyathanumeyam iti chet evamapyanirmoksha prasangaha. Tarka pratishthanadapyanyathanumeyam iti chet evamapyanirmoksha prasangaha. So the Siddhanti says Tarka apratishthana, sorry, the Purvapakshi makes an arapa. Siddhanti is saying Kevala Tarka having Virodha with Samanvaya is no Virodha at all. Samanvaya of what? Of Vedanti claiming that all Vedanta Vakyas are tuned towards revealing Aikya with Brahma. Jiva Brahma Aikya, basically revealing Brahma, committed to Brahma, and then Aikya of that Brahma with Jiva. So that kind of a Samanvaya, even if you see Virodha with your Tarka is no good. It is not good enough to show any compromise of Samanvaya in Brahma. So why is that so? Because Tarka has no Pratishtha in Shruti, and not having Pratishtha in Shruti, in Vedanta you cannot land on a conclusive assertion the way you are making, you the Tarkikas or Sankhyas are making. Why? Because another Tarka can be shown to compromise your own Anumana. That is why Tarkikas, when they do charcha, it can go endless unless some doshas can be pointed out or an answer cannot be given. A person, if he makes 3 mistakes, he is out. Or if he is unable to show that how his paksha is right, when the other makes an objection, that not being able to answer also means that you are out. Therefore, Tarka can use Chala also, just to win over. There can be Vitanda also. I don't have to prove anything, just disproving you, I can win. That kind of a process is not conclusive. Therefore, Pratishtha is not there in Tarka. So what is said is that, if one Tarka seems valid, another Tarka opposing that also seems valid. Even today in science, some other theory comes up, hypothesis, which disproves the earlier established acceptable by all scientists, that kind of a theory also, that kind of a theory or a hypothesis is refuted by another new hypothesis that comes up by different scientists, and that holds good till that is also refuted. So it's a never ending process. Even what is verifiable in a lab can have some other explanation by some other scientist, and then that explanation will go for a toss. So tarka is also like that. In modern science also we see such inconclusiveness is there. As the time progresses, you see that across an era, you can very well see that it's an ongoing process. There is nothing conclusive as in idam ittham. Then when Siddhanti says that, therefore your objection is not valid to counter my samanvaya, if the Siddhanti says that, then Purvapakshi says that tarka apratishthanad api, even if tarka does not have a conclusive end, meaning it can be on shaky ground, even if it is on shaky ground, some other tarka may be solid. So it is not that all tarka is on shaky ground. So some tarka can be having no virodha by any tarka, you cannot counter it. So it is conclusive. How do you say that it is not conclusive? So tarka pratishthanad api anyatha anumeyam. Anyatha anumeyam is another way. If my process of landing on something using tarka is being opposed by others and I am unable to go forward and establish the conclusion the way I have landed upon, the end that I have landed upon, I cannot go ahead through this process, then I can use another kind of an anumana and land on a conclusive goal. So anyatha anumeyam, I use another process of tarka and land on my goal, so I can conclude iti ched. This much is purvapaksha. If that is the case, then evam api, even in that case, Siddhanti says anirmoksha prasanga, moksha won't be possible. Why will moksha not be possible? The reason is that you have established based on tarka, and moksha is for a jiva. Which jiva? That jiva who is separate from the body, mind, sense complex. That kind of a jivatma is known only through the shruti. Paramatma is known through the Shruti. If at all one says that, oh, through Tarka I can know that I am different from the body, fine. You can do an analysis and land on that kind of an entity which is different from the body, but you will land on the mind. If you say I am different from the mind also by using Sushupti analysis without any inputs from the Shruti, still you will land on that entity which is separate from the body, mind, sense complex, but this entity has some kind of a moksha possible. Moksha which is nitya, that I live across janmas, that there is janma for me and I live across janmas through different bodies. This kind of a thing cannot be established by tarka, by kevala tarka. You will need shruti as pramana, because for atindriya vishaya shruti alone is pramana. Atma is atindriya, not indriya gochara. So indriya agocharana shruti reva pramanam. Thereby, even if you establish something, that established thing will not lead to moksha using tarka. Using kevala tarka, whatever you do without shruti as a basis, that ashabda will not lead to moksha at all. Any ashabda sadhana, any sadhana which is not based in shruti cannot give moksha. Independent meditation, whatever dhyana you do, or vipassana ityadi, you can land on your own self being different from the body, mind, sense complex. But that inquiry also, even if it is based on Sankhya, meaning Jnana, still it will not lead to moksha unless you have Shruti Pramana. And if you take Shruti Pramana wholesale, you will land on Aikya. There is no other way out. If you take Shruti proper, all the Shrutis, and try to do Mimamsa without any contradiction, resolving contradiction, you have to land on Advaita. There is no other way. No Advaita conclusion will stand scrutiny when you take all Vakyas as valid. You cannot explain them otherwise. Therefore, Shuddha Tarka Bahuduram as sadhana for moksha, that will lead to Anirmoksha Prasanga. Vritti Yatnatha Ekena Tarkikena Anumitaha Api Arthaha Anyena Shrestatarena Anyatha Niyate Iti Kevalasya Tarkasya Apratishthanadapi. Yatnatha. So, with a lot of effort, using 5 steps or 3 steps, multiple steps basically, using Lakshana, whatever you use, so many Hetus, I mean analysis of the Hetu so that you don't have Hetuabhasa, doing all of that, Tarkika has established something, Artha Anumitaha, Tarkikena. So, Ekena Tarkikena Yatnataha Anumitaha Pi Artha. Something he has landed on using lot of effort and he feels good about it. Here it is. Here is my Hetu. Here is my Sadhya. There is no Hetuabhasa. Then what the other does is that Anyena Tarkikena, another Tarkika takes it up as a challenge and uses all his knowledge that he has to back him up, and then he shows a Hetuabhasa or something and shows some flaws. So Shrestha Tarena Anyatha Niyate. He says that we will use your same sadhana, but your sadhana will not lead to this sadhya, it will lead to another sadhya. Or to land into this sadhya, you will have to use another hetu because this hetu has a flaw. So anyatha niyate, some other way, there can be a counter, and either there are flaws in the hetu, therefore you cannot land on this particular sadhya, or if your hetu is valid, then it will land on another sadhya, not this sadhya, thereby your tarka is not right, says another tarkika. Anyatha niyate iti kevalasya tarkasya apratishthana. Therefore, there is no pratishtha to kevala tarka, shuddha tarka, without any other pramana backing it. So, apratishthana dapi, tarkasya apratishthana dapi, apratishthitatvaccha na tena samanvaya virodha shankha ityartha. So, even if there is an issue with the tarka, another tarka can establish. Therefore, so na tena samanvaya virodha shankha, says the Siddhanti. So, having said that, so api, this api should be read as cha here from the Siddhanti's point of view. So, tarkasya apratishthanadapi means apratishthitatvaccha na tena samanvaya virodha shankha, says the Siddhanti. Purvapakshi says api means even so, he says that anyatha anumeyam. Therefore, samanvaya virodha is there. Samanvaya virodha shankha at least is there. How does he see that? Nanu kasyachit tarkasya apratishthitatve api kasyachit pratishthitatva sambhava tena samanvaya virodha shanka yukta iti akshipati. Purvapakshi says kasyachit tarkasya apratishthitatvam bhavatu. Even if some tarka has a flaw, another tarka can be used. So kasyachit pratishthitatva sambhavat, some other tarka can hold good and still land on the same goal. So I'll change my hetu and come up with a new tarka, and then thereby I can establish the same sadhya, thereby samanvaya virodha shanka, your samanvaya will fall apart, your siddhantis, vedantis samanvaya will fall apart. At least that such doubt is possible. Yukta iti akshipati anyatha anumeyam iti chet. So apratishthita tarka, tarkadanyena prakarena, with another methodology, pratishthita tarkena, which has no opposition, हेत्वाभासः इज नॉट देयर, हेतु साध्य हैज अ गुड बेसिस, देयर बाय प्रतिष्ठित तर्केण समन्वय विरोधाद समन्वय विरोधादिकम अनुमेयम इति चेत, देयर बाय व्हाट विल हैपन इज दैट समन्वय विरोध इज लॉजिकल, इज अ लॉजिकल कंक्लूजन, बिकॉज यू कैनॉट हैव टू एंड्स. इफ माई तर्का कैनॉट बी अपोज, देन यूअर एस्टैब्लिश्ड साध्य विल फॉल अपार्ट, समन्वय इति चेत अत्र समाधत्ते, समाधान इज गिवन बाय सिद्धांत एवं अपि. इवन सो लेट्स एज्यूम दैट केवल तर्क हैज एस्टैब्लिश समथिंग, इवन सो व्हाट हैपेंस अन्यत्र तर्कस्य प्रतिष्ठितत्वे अपि प्रकृते लिंगादिहीने ब्रह्मणि वेद निरपेक्षस्य तर्कस्य अप्रतिष्ठितत्व दोषात् अनिर्मोक्ष प्रसंगः. इवन देन योर शुद्ध तर्क कांट लीड टू मोक्ष. वाई सो? Even if the tarka has no opposition, anyatra tarkasya pratishthitatve api, and you can land on your sadhya, then prakruta is in the context, there is brahma. Brahma is what you are dealing with. Lingadi hine brahmani. So for example, just look, anyatra tarkasya pratishthitatve api. Look at this. Take an example of parvato vanniman. Why? Dhumatvat. So on parvata you are seeing dhuma, you are seeing smoke on the mountain, you cannot see fire, but you conclude with anumana as to what, tarka as what, parvatah vanniman, there is fire on the mountain. So mountain has fire. Why? Because you see smoke, because of the mountain having smoke. Now the issue is that it is windy. It is windy, and let's say there has been a fire on the other side of the mountain. Mountain does not have fire, but there is some higher ground across the mountain. You cannot see that because the mountain is blocking your sight. And that fire, although it is not on the mountain, the smoke has come up on the mountain due to the wind. Then what happens is that you are seeing smoke on the mountain and your conclusion is that there is fire on the mountain, but that tarka is wrong. Why? Because there is no fire on the mountain, the fire is in some village behind the mountain, on a higher ground maybe, but that village is not on the mountain. Thereby your analysis based on tarka would be apratishthita, says the siddhanti. Then anyatra tarkasya pratishthitatve api, the tarkika says that my hetu I'll refine, I'll not say dhumatvat, but I'll say अविच्छिन्न मूल रेखया धूमत्वात्. सो वेर इज रियली दी स्मोक टू बी सीन टू कंक्लूड दैट देर इज फायर. दी स्मोक शुड बी ट्रेसेबल टू दी ग्राउंड, टू दी अधिष्ठान. सो ड्यू टू दी विंड द स्मोक विल हैव नो कॉन्टैक्ट विद दी ग्राउंड. We don't want that kind of a smoke as hetu for sadhya vanni. So the Purvapakshi says that when I say dhumatvat, I do not mean any dhuma, yakaschit dhuma, I mean avichinna moola rekhaya dhumatvat. I mean that dhuma which is traceable to the ground where there is fire. Only that kind of dhuma is hetu in my case. Then such a smoke will definitely tell you that there is fire on the mountain. But if the smoke is just a cloud of smoke and you do not see a line tracing back to the ground, in the example where there is a village on fire which is behind the mountain will not have this smoke tracing to the ground. Therefore, you cannot say Parvato Vanniman. So I'll never have that kind of a conclusion, says the Purva Pakshi Tarkika, and thereby Anyatra Tarkasya Pratishtitatve Api. Siddhanti has to answer. He says Prakrute Lingadi Hine Brahmani. This Brahma does not have linga, like your Dhuma is a linga in the case of Vanni, be that Dhuma which is traceable to the ground. But there is no linga in the case of Brahma. So Lingadi Hine Brahmani, Prakrute Brahmani, in the context of the Vedanta or in the context of Brahma, Moksha Vishaya, there you have to understand Paramatma Brahma, that Brahma is Lingadi Hina. And Tasmin Brahmani Vishaye Veda Nirapekshasya Tarkasya Apratishtitatva Doshat Anirmoksha Prasangaha. So this Tarka, which is Kevala Tarka that you are using, does not have any apeksha of Veda. There is no Veda Vakya needed for your Tarka. You never use Veda Vakya and then use Tarka on that. What do? You say that I have established this Sadhya using Hetu, and thereby my Tarka is strong, it is irrefutable, and then you say, oh, Shruti also says something like this. So that Shruti also says versus Shruti says so and my Tarka is based on Shruti are two different things. The Tarka that we use for Manana, Vedantis, we use that Tarka which is approved by the Shruti, which has foundation in Shruti, which traces back to the conclusion in Shruti. But your Kevala Tarka, Tarkika's Kevala Tarka or Sankhya's Tarka, lands on something which is opposed to Shruti. Therefore, Veda Nirapekshasya Tarkasya. Tarka is what? Veda Nirapeksha. Has no dependency on Veda at all. That Tarka has Apratishtitatva Dosha. It will not be able to conclude because there will be an opposition from Shruti, which is a main Pramana really. Because you are Nastika as well. You are not Nastika, you are Astika. So if the Veda says something and your Tarka says something else, then your Tarka has to be set aside. There is no other way. So Tarkasya Apratishtitatva Doshat Anirmoksha Prasangaha. There will be no moksha possible. Moksha is possible only through Shruti Vakya. Yadva. Otherwise, Purva Pakshi says, hey, my Tarka, Tarka Shastra is not made by any Tom, Dick and Harry. It is made by these Munis. Mananath Muni. Munihi. So you Vedanti says Mananath Munihi, so are Kapila Muni, Kanada Muni, all these have created these Shastras, Tarka, Nyaya Vaisheshika Shastra. So you cannot say that these Diggajas have created Shastra and that will give no moksha. You cannot make such objection, says the Purva Pakshi. To that the answer is Yadva. Mahatam Kapila Kanadadinam Paraspara Vipratipannaihi Agava Nirapekshaihi Tarkaihi Tattva Niranaya Abhavad Anirmoksha Prasangaha. He says even so your Tarka will be opposed by another Tarka, because other than a Vedantin everybody is a Shuddha Tarkika. Even Nastikas are using Tarka, Astikas are using Tarka to establish something that they have concluded without any basis in Shruti, other than Advaita Vedantin. Therefore, even if they are really respectable, Kapila and Kanadi may be Mahan Vyaktis, Mahan Munis also, we have respect there. In fact, Bhagavan Shankaracharya calls the Tarkika Acharya, Tarkashastra Acharya as Acharya. He says, we agree that he is an Acharya. We have also learned from their Shastras as to how to build up logic. We agree. We do not agree with their philosophical perspective, but we agree with the analysis that can be done using such constructs. And using those very constructs, we will show that your Tarka is flawed. Meaning the followers of Tarka Shastra, they are not using Tarka the way it is there in their original Grantha, because if they use it, then there will be contradiction there also. So, Yadva Mahatam Kapila Kanadadi Nam Paraspara Vipratipannehi Tarkaihi, the Tarka which is concluding differently from each other. So, Agama Nirapeksha, that Tarka is what? Agama Nirapeksha Tarka has no basis on Tarka, but even if they are by these munis, still they will be opposed to each other. So, if you take Tarkikas themselves, why do we have division of Nyaya and Vaisheshika? Today it may not be existent, but earlier it was there. There was, although there is Samya, some similarity between, or a lot of similarity, let's say, between Nyaya and Vaisheshika darshanas, still there is a difference as well. In number of pramanas, in number of padarthas, there is so much variation. Why is there so much variation? Therefore, the process is different. Although same tarka is used, similar tarka is used, the process is also different, the conclusion is also different. So, they are all opposed to each other. And then comes in Sankhya with his own tarka. He is also opposing. Then Yoga comes up with one's own. Anubhava also into place, and then that is also opposing. He is also going to use Tarka. Then Bauddha comes in, he says that I'll use only Tarka. You have also been using only Tarka, but you say Shruti also says that we don't agree with your Shruti as Pramana. So he is going to use Shruddha Tarka. Jaina will also do that. And thereby Paraspara Vipratipannaihi Agama Nirapekshahi, where there is no apeksha of Agama Veda at all. Tarkaihi tattva niranaya abhavat, you cannot conclude idam ittham. This is exactly so. Thereby what will happen? Anirmoksha prasanga. Bauddhas will not have no moksha, Jainas will have no moksha, but you will also not have any moksha. Although you are astikas. Tasmad agama virodhi tarkaha apramanam iti na tena virodha iti siddham. Therefore, even if you show any virodha, we don't care using your tarka, because your tarka is kevala tarka. That Virodha is not strong enough to take away Shruti Nishchayaha. Ukta Nyayam Anyatra Ati Dishati. The Adhikarana is over with this last sutra. And now the fourth Adhikarana in the first part of second chapter is Shishta Aparigraha Adhikaranam. Here the same Nyaya which has been used is being extended. Therefore, there is no Sangati here. Separate Sangati is not needed. So, Shishta Aparigraha Adhikaranam. How it is being extended? Saying that Shishta, Manu, Vyasa, Ityadi, they have their own Granthas where they have shown that whatever these Satkaryavadis, Sankhyas are using as their Darshana, to show their Darshana, are using whatever logic they are using to establish, that is opposed, that is refuted by Vedanti. A similar logic can be used to use other Aumshas used by others. Whatever Aumsha has been refuted by Vedanti in the Sankhyas, Sankhya Darshana, to refute the Sankhya Darshana, similar logic can be used with other Aumshas in Sankhya also and in Tarka also. So, similar logic will refute the other parts of such darshana. So, wherever there is an overlap, other aushas will also stand refuted if you refute one part of the one ausha of the darshana. That is the Ukta Nyayam Anyatra Atidishati. And why? Because Shishta Aparigraha is there. Shishtaihi, the Pradhana Vada of the Sankhyas, is one Aumsha. There, Shishta Aparigraha, meaning Shishtaihi Aparigrihitaha. Aparigraha is Aparigrihita. They, by the Shishtas in the Sampradaya, none of these anshas of the sankhyas tarkikas has been accepted, none of the anshas have been accepted as pramana. They don't consider them as pramana. So if you take their perspective, who are respected very well in the sampradaya across the board, you cannot say that tarkika has no respect for manu or vyasacharya. So thereby they have not used their darshanas, the other darshanas, as pramana at all. Mean the philosophical aspects have not been considered as pramana. Therefore, shishta aparigraha becomes a hetu, and that is the first sutra. Etena shishta aparigraha api vyakhyataha. Etena shishta aparigraha api vyakhyataha. Using what has been the methodology which has been used, using that very methodology, through that etena shishta aparigraha api vyakhyataha. Whatever has not been acceptable to the shishtas, even that has been included here as though commented. So in a single sutra, even those anshas which have not been refuted stand refuted, says the siddhanti. Asya atideshatvat na prithak sangatya peksha, because it is only an extension of what has already been said. There is no separate sangati, the same sangati holds good. And phalam tu purvavat, if the sangati is similar, phala is also similar. What is a phala? Samanvaya siddhi as per the siddhanti, and Purva Pakshi says samanvaya asiddhi. Brahmana jagadupadanam, so jagadupadana karana is not Brahma, says the Purva Pakshi. Why? He uses tarka. Tarkika says vibhutvat vyomavat. So vyomavat vibhutvat, vyoma is akasha. So akasha is vibhu, is all pervasive. And your Brahma is also all pervasive. Now how can all pervasive become karana? Because karana is for some karya, that karya is limited. Your karya is limitless, meaning it is available everywhere. Then how can something which is available everywhere become the basis or karana for something which is limited in space? Just like space is not karana, akasha is not karana for any karya, ghatapatadi. Ghatapatadi are at a particular place, and akasha, which is karana, you think is karana, is everywhere. Therefore, it is not karana, says the Purvapakshi Tarkika. And using that tarka, he says, similarly, your Brahma is vibhu, all pervasive, and therefore, this limitless Brahma cannot become karana for limited jagat, which is karya, ghatapatadi jagat, which is limited. So brahmana jagat upadanam vibhutvat vyomavat. So he is using that kind of a vyapti. So he says what? Yatra yatra vyoma, yatra yatra vibhutvam, tatra tatra na upadanatvam. Specifically jagat upadanatvam na yatha vyoma. So he says yatha akasha. So akasha is everywhere. So wherever there is vibhutva, there is no upadana karanatvam. Jagad upadana karanatvam is not there. Using that vyapti, he says ityadi tarkika bhimata nyayena. He says this has become a nyayana. So wherever there is vibhutvam, that vibhu padartha cannot become karana for jagat. Upadana karana it cannot be. It is not a material cause. So acceptable by tarkikas, such nyaya, through that nyaya, Brahma karanatva bodhaka samanvaya virudhyate nava iti sandehe virudhyate iti purva paksha. So is there a virodha in the siddhanti samanvaya, where Brahma karanatva is established, bodhaka samanvaya. So samanvaya which says what? The samanvaya which gives the bodha jnana of Brahma being karana. That kind of a samanvaya virodha is there or is it not there? When such a doubt is there, Purvapakshi says that our nyaya opposes, and thereby virodha is there, samanvaya virodha, and therefore samanvaya asiddhi. Siddhantastu, Vedanti says etena manvadibhi shishtaihi. So shishta aparigraha means what? Shishtaihi aparigraha, aparigrahitaha. Who are the shishtas? Manu ityadi. So Manu, Vyasa, Acharya, all these are shishtas. We follow whatever they are doing. They are shishtas. So we say they know dharma better than us. So if we don't find any pramana, we follow whatever they have followed, they have said. Thereby, शिष्टैः मन्वादिभिः शिष्टैः केनचित् सत्कार्यवादाद्यंशेन परिगृहीत प्रधानवाद निराकरण प्रकारेण शिष्टा परिग्रहाः. सो व्हाई हैव दे शिष्टास नॉट एक्सेप्टेड एनीथिंग निराकरण प्रकारेण. दे हैव ऑल्सो एग्रीड विद दी रिफ्यूटेशन. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ रिफ्यूटेशन? परिगृहीत प्रधानवाद निराकरण. सो दी प्रधानवाद विच इज एक्सेप्टेबल टू हूसोएवर दैट बिकम्स वन अंश एंड सम दर्शनाज हैव एक्सेप्टेड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल प्रधान कारणवाद हैज बीन एक्सेप्टेड बाय सांख्याज एंड योगीज. सो परिगृहित प्रधानवाद निराकरण हैज बीन डन बाय वेदांति. दैट निराकरण प्रकार इज एक्सेप्टेबल टू शिष्टाज. सो एतेन मन्वादिभिः शिष्टैः केनचित् सत्कार्यवाद आदि अंशेन. सो सत्कार्यवाद अंश इज व्हाट दिस प्रधानवाद इज वन पार्ट ऑफ इट. Others can use some satkaryavada with other aushas. So if one ausha is refuted, the same methodology can be used to refute other aushas also. So shishtaihi kenachid api aushena aparigrihitaha. The other aushas have not been accepted. Some aushas, satkaryavada ausha, like pradhanavada has been refuted. So shishtas accept that. And they have not accepted the other aushas. Kenachid api aushena aparigrihita. They have not accepted any ausha of these सत्कार्यवादास सच एज यूज इन अदर दर्शना. सो अणुवादि कारणवाद व्याख्याता निरस्ता द्रष्टव्य. सो अणु बीइंग द कारण, परमाणु बीइंग द कारण फॉर नैयायिकाज एंड वैशेषिकाज, सच काइंड ऑफ अ कारणवाद हैज ऑल्सो बीन कॉमेंटेड अपॉन बिकॉज दे हैव नॉट बीन एक्सेप्टेड बाय शिष्टाज. देर बाय दे आर ऑल्सो व्याख्याता निरस्ता द्रष्टव्य. कॉमेंटेड एंड रिफ्यूटेड एज दो. वी डोंट नीड अ सेपरेट रिफ्यूटेशन. एंड दिस वॉज सेड इन द क्लोजिंग ऑफ द फोर्थ पाद ऑफ द फर्स्ट अध्याय. अतः तार्किक न्याय से वेद बाधितत्वात् न तेन विरोध इति सिद्धम. देर फोर वॉट एवर न्याय is acceptable to tarkikas, they all come together and say we accept. Oh, this logic is brilliant, we have absolutely no issues, and this will become an axiom for others. So this is all well established, we don't need to reinvent the wheel. So whatever nyaya has been set in stone by tarkikas has to be used by everyone. We say not everyone, you use it, we don't care. Why? Vedabaditatvat. सो अतः तार्किक न्याय से वॉट एवर न्याय इज एक्सेप्टेबल टू तार्किकाज एज सेट इन स्टोन, दे मे यूज इट एज एन एग्जियम एज एग्जियम्स, बट वी हैव नो सच एग्रीमेंट एट ऑल. वी हैव नो सच कंपल्शन टू एग्री. वाई? बिकॉज वेदबाधितत्वात् दे आर रिफ्यूटेड बाय वेदास. सो फॉर अस मूल प्रमाण विल ऑलवेज बी वेदास. सो इफ यूर तर्का which is an established nyaya, which is an axiom for you, let it be. We don't want to fall in a pit with you. So for us, moksha is important. We don't want anirmoksha prasanga. So Veda refutation will supersede your axiom, Veda badi tattvat na tena virodha iti siddham. Therefore, you show samanvaya virodha by using any established nyaya or axiom for you. We couldn't care any less. Says the, so there is no virodha at all, says the Siddhanti. Purvam brahmani tarkasya apratishtitatve api jagadbhede pratyakshasya pratishtitatvad virudhyate eva iti pratyudharana sangatya idamah. Now this Purvapakshi says, okay, our axioms, what you think they are axioms for us, they are established nyaya, acceptable to anyone who uses tarka as pramana. For you, they are no basis, they are not a foundation. Even if we say they are not a foundation for you, therefore there is no samanvaya virodha. Even if you say and we accept, okay, let's take that, because there is no common ground. You say that this tarka, which is a nyaya, is not a nyaya for you, it is not an axiom for you, it is not an established fact for you. But still, is pratyaksha acceptable or not? Our tarka is based on pratyaksha, all right, but pratyaksha has to be acceptable to you. The Vedanti, because Pratyaksha is also Jyeshta Pramana. You cannot say only Shruti is Pramana. Even your own Acharya say that if the Shruti says that the fire is cold, do not accept it. Why? Because Pratyaksha Virodha is there. So Pratyaksha Virodha should make Pratyaksha as a Jyeshta Pramana. So wherever you have Pratyaksha Virodha, there Pratyaksha should be a superior Pramana. And you should set aside your conclusion based on Vedas. Why? Because you yourself have said, your own Acharyas have said that if the Shruti says that the fire is cold, through Pratyaksha you know that fire is not cold, therefore you should set aside that Shruti and take Pratyaksha as a Pramana. Haven't you said that? Haven't your own people said that? So we say, yes, we have said that, but has any Shruti said that fire is cold? It has not. But if something similar is there, we say that whatever is the scope of Pratyaksha, there Shruti has no scope. Shruti has scope as Pramanyam. Shruti has Pramanyam only in Atindriya Vishaya. So that is what is meant by, if the Shruti says fire is cold, then fire is not cold is known through Pratyaksha, because fire is not Atindriya, it is Indriya Gochara Vishaya. So Atindriya Gochara Vishaya cannot have opposition by Pratyaksha at all, because it is not in the scope of Pratyaksha at all. This is our Siddhanta really. But the Purvapakshi says that Purvam Brahmani Tarkasya Apratishthitatve Api, although there is no Pratishtha of Tarka, Tarka has no foundation in the case of Brahma, to argue in the case of Brahma, Tathapi Jagadbhede Pratyakshasya Pratishthitatva, Pratyaksha establishes Dvaita, Bheda in Jagat. You cannot say Advaita because Pratyaksha Virodha is there. Thereby Virudhyate Eva, Samanvaya Virodha is definitely there. Brahmani Samanvaya Vaikya Samanvaya Nasti Eva. Kutaha Jagadbhede Pratyakshasya Pramanyam, Jyeshta Pramanyam Asti, Khalu. So he says Jyeshta Pramanyam, it is Pratyaksha is showing you Dvaita. How can you say Advaita? Iti Pratyudharana Sangatya Idamaha. Thereby, there is a counter example to the Siddhanti, and thereby Bhoktarapatyadikaranam. So Bhoktarapatyadikaranam, there should be double takara here, it's a typo. So there should be a double takara. I'll mark it so that I remember to fix. So Bhoktarapatti Adhikaranam. What is Bhoktarapatti Adhikaranam? We'll look at in this sutra. Bhoktarapattir avibhagaschet syallokavat. Bhoktarapattir avibhagaschet syallokavat. So Bhoktarapattehe avibhagaha chet syat lokavat. Earlier I have not done padachheda. I'll skip this. So I mean earlier you can do on your own if at all it is needed. So Bhoktarapatte he avibhagaha chet iti chet, if at all Bhoktarapatti hi, meaning Bhogya will become Bhokta. So Bhokta Bhogya Bheda is there. There is a Triputi. So Karta, Karma and Kriya, this division is there. So if you set aside Kriya also and just look at Karta and Karma, in the Bhojana Kriya Bhokta is there and Bhojya is there, Bhogya. So that Bhogya Anna, let's say Anna, you are eating food, you are the Bhokta. Food is Anna, is Bhogya. So this Bhogya and Bhokta will become one. So Bhoktarapatti, there is a Bhoktarapatti. Why? Because there is only Advaita, you are saying. So due to that Advaita, your Bhokta and Bhogya Bheda won't be there, says the Purvapakshi. And thereby what will happen? The one who consumes the food एंड वन हु दैट विच इज ईटन दे आर बोथ सेम इज इट रियली पॉसिबल एंड ड्यू टू दैट भोक्तरापत्ते हे ड्यू टू भोक्तरापत्ति ही भोग्या बिकमिंग भोक्ता ड्यू टू वननेस बिटवीन भोक्ता एंड भोग्य विभाग अविभाग विभाग वोंट बी पॉसिबल देर इज अ भोक्ता एंड भोग्य विभाग देन देर इज अ भोजन क्रिया विभाग एंड वेन ऑल दीज थ्री कम इन द अदर्स विल ऑल्सो अदर कारकाज विल स्टेप इन इफ यू एक्सेप्ट वन कारक देर विल बी अदर वन कारक भेद यू एक्सेप्ट एवरी वन विल स्टेप इन सो वेन यू से त्रिपुटी इज एक्सेप्टेबल एज सून एज यू एक्सेप्ट त्रिपुटी द भोक्ता इज कर्ता भोग्य इज कर्म कर्म कारक देन देर इज अ क्रिया मीनिंग भाव इन कृदंता वॉट यू से भावे व्युत्पत्ति सो क्रिया इज भाव और इन तिंगंता भाव इज देर सो क्रिया दैट्स अ थर्ड वेर आर दीज टेकिंग प्लेस दैट क्वेश्चन विल कम अप एंड देन अधिकरण कारक विल ऑल्सो स्टेप इन सो अनदर भेद विल स्टेप इन देर फॉर द्वैता इज नॉट रियली ड्युअलिटी इट इज ऑल प्लुरैलिटी ओनली देर इज मल्टीप्लिसिटी एज सून एज द्वितीय स्टेप्स इन ऑल विल कम अलॉन्ग देर इज अ फैमिली इट्स नॉट दैट यू नो सपरिवार दिल एंटर सो ड्युअलिटी इज एक्चुअली प्लुरैलिटी इट इज नॉट ओनली टू बिकॉज देर इज भेदा बिटवीन वेन यू से द्वैता भेदा बिटवीन हुम एंड हुम सो यू से बिटवीन हु ऑल इज देर इज भेदा बिटवीन जीव एंड परमात्मा बट डू यू स्टॉप देर नो बिटवीन द जगत एंड जीव ऑल्सो देर इज भेदा जगत एंड परमात्मा देर इज भेदा जीव एंड जीवा देर इज भेदा बिटवीन जगत पार्ट ऑफ जगत एंड अनदर पार्ट ऑफ जगत देर इज भेदा सो कंप्लीटली देर इज भेदा सो इट इज नॉट ड्युअलिटी इट इज ऑल प्लुरैलिटी देर बाय भोक्तरापत्ते हे अविभाग चेत देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ सच विभाग इफ एट ऑल भोक्ता एंड भोग्य बिकम वन देन हाउ विल यू से भोक्ता इज अनदर एंड मी अन्य भोक्ता अन्य भोग्य अन्य हाउ विल यू से दैट यू कैनॉट से सच थिंग एट ऑल बट सच अ थिंग इज देर इन प्रत्यक्ष देर फॉर वॉट भोक्ता कैनॉट बी भोग्य भोग्य कैनॉट बी भोक्ता यू कैनॉट हैव वननेस एट ऑल इति चेत इफ एट ऑल दैट इज द आक्षेप देन द सिद्धांति सेज स्यात् लोकवत Though you see such examples of Bheda being there, although there is a Bheda Pratiti being there, although there is a Bheda, you see that in Loka itself, I'll show you. We'll look at this in the Tika, otherwise there will be repetition, like what we had in the first Sutra discussed today. There's a lot of repetition. I myself get bored with repetition. I'm sure you would also get bored in repetition, because in a Vritti there is nothing more if everything is said in the Sutra itself. But what does Sutra say? Lokavat Syat. In the world, I'll give you an example that although there is oneness, still there is a Bheda Pratiti. And Bheda Pratiti in Pratyaksha will not oppose the real Advaita. Therefore, Bhokta and Bhogya, Vibhaga is possible. Syat, Vibhaga Pratiti is Syat. And that will have no opposition with Samanvaya of Aikya because Real Aikya can not be opposed. We'll show you with an example with in Loka itself, says the Siddhanti. Vritti, Phalantu Purvavata. Meaning what? Samanvaya Asiddhi as per Purvapakshi and Samanvaya Siddhi as per Siddhanti. Advitiya Brahmana Jagat Sargam Bruvan Samanvayaha Pratyakshena Virudhyate Navayati Sandehe. When there is a doubt as to is there a Virodha with Pratyaksha of Samanvaya in Brahma? Advaita, Advitiya Brahmana Jagat Sargam Bruvan. So this Advitiya Brahma has become Karana for Jagat which is created. Creation of Jagat is from this Advitiya Brahma. So one who is saying such Bruvan, what is he saying? He is saying that the created Jagat is having Karanatva of Advitiya Brahma. So Bruvan Samanvayaha Pratyakshena Virudhyate. So Bruvan Samanvaya, the Samanvaya is establishing this and that kind of a Samanvaya which is showing the Karanatva of Advitiya Brahma for a variegated Jagat as Karya Pratyakshena Virudhyate Vana. Samanvaya is opposed by Pratyaksha or not. When such a doubt is there, Advitiya Brahmana Jagat Upadanatve Bhoktru Bhogya Prapanchasya Sarvasya ब्रह्म अनन्यत्वेन भोग्य शब्दादेहे भोक्त्रात्मकत्वापत्तेहे भोक्तृभोग्यात्मकत्वापत्तेहे प्रत्यक्ष सिद्धिः परस्पर विभाग न स्यात्। अतः प्रत्यक्षेण समन्वयः विरुध्यते इति चेद् इति पूर्वपक्षः। सो पूर्वपक्षस्य देयर इज अ विरोध विद प्रत्यक्ष। व्हाट इज विरोध? ही सेज दैट अद्वितीय ब्रह्मणः जगत उपादानत्वे उपादानत्वे सति। इफ एट ऑल यू एक्सेप्ट दैट देयर इज अद्वितीय ब्रह्म विच इज कारण उपादान कारण फॉर जगत, देन भोक्तृभोग्य प्रपंचस्य द प्रपंच इज फुल ऑफ दीज ड्युअलिटीज ऑफ कर्ता एंड कर्म बीइंग सेपरेट। सो इज जस्ट टेकन दैट एग्जाम्पल, भोक्ता इज सेपरेट, भोग्य इज सेपरेट एंड सर्वस्य एंटायरली द वर्ल्ड इज फुल ऑफ दिस कर्ता कर्म पेयर। सो सर्वस्य भोक्तृभोग्य प्रपंचस्य ब्रह्म अनन्यत्वेन, यू आर क्लेमिंग अनन्यत्व बिकॉज भोक्ता इज सेपरेट, भोग्य इज सेपरेट इन द प्रपंच, इन द कंप्लीट प्रपंच, सर्व प्रपंचस्य सर्वस्य भोक्ता अन्यः भोग्य अन्य। और इन ईच एंड एवरी एस्पेक्ट दैट यू एनालाइज इन प्रपंच भोक्ता इज अन्य भोग्य इज अन्य। सो इफ भोक्ता इज अन्य एंड भोग्य इज अन्य यू आर सेइंग ब्रह्म अनन्यत्व। सो भोक्ता ब्रह्म अनन्य भोग्यम अपि ब्रह्म अनन्यत्। सो व्हेन यू से सच अ थिंग देन भोक्ता एंड भोग्य बीइंग ब्रह्म अनन्य विल बिकम वन, भोक्ता एंड भोग्य विल ऑल्सो बिकम वन एंड देयर बाय भोग्य शब्दादेहे विभाग न स्यात्। यू कैनॉट हैव भोग्य शब्द, यू कैनॉट हैव भोक्ता शब्द ऑल्सो। वाई? बिकॉज पदार्थास आर नॉट डिफरेंट, दे आर ऑल वन, देयर फोर द शब्द प्रयोग कैनॉट मेक। नोबडी सेज यू नो घटा कुंभ च अस्ति व्हेन ओनली वन घटा इज देयर एंड दैट इटसेल्फ इज कुंभ ऑल्सो। यू डोंट से घटा कुंभ च अस्ति और स्तः घटा कुंभश्च भवतः, यू डो नॉट से सच अ थिंग। वाई? बिकॉज घटा इज इक्वल टू कुंभ, यू कैनॉट हैव when ghata is equal to kumbha, there are different ghata and kumbha, then it's a different story, but ghata and kumbha are one. If they are one, there is only one ghata, one calls it as a ghata, another calls it as kumbha, it's a large pot, so one can call it as kumbha also. When such a padartha division is not possible, then pada division does not make any sense, shabda has no meaning. So bhogya shabda dehe avibhagasyat, मीनिंग वॉट भोक्तरात्मकत्वापत्ते, बिकॉज भोग्य शब्दादेहे भोक्तरात्मकत्वापत्ते हे भोग्य शब्द इज ऑल्सो भोक्ता अलोन। सो पदार्थ इज बिकॉज भोग्य शब्द लीड्स टू ब्रह्म, भोक्ता शब्द ऑल्सो लीड्स टू ब्रह्म, देर फोर भोग्य शब्द इज भोक्तरात्मक, देर फोर भोक्तृभोग्यात्मकत्वापत्ते भोक्तु विल बिकम भोग्य एंड देर बाय प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध परस्पर विभाग न स्या। बट विभाग इज देर इन प्रत्यक्ष, भोक्ता इज डिफरेंट, भोग्य इज डिफरेंट। नोबडी सेज दैट आई एम दिस फूड, अहम अन्नम इज अ मंत्र ऑल राइट, तैतरीय मंत्र, बट नोबडी सेज अहम अन्नम इन लोक। सो प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध इज अहम अन्नम न, अन्नम भोग्यम, अहम तो भोक्ता, दैट डिविजन इज देर। सो दैट प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध परस्पर विभाग न सैत्। बट अस्ति तु, देयरफॉर व्हाट? अर्थापत्ति प्रमाण, प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध परस्पर विभाग न स्याद् भवति तु, अतः अन्यथा अनुपपत्य युवर ऐक्यय समन्वय असिद्ध। यू कैन सी अन्यथा अनुपपत्ति एंड देयरफॉर अर्थापत्ति प्रमाण बीइंग यूज्ड बाय द पूर्वपक्षी, अतः प्रत्यक्षेण समन्वय विरुध्यते। ऑफकोर्स देयर इज नो अर्थापत्ति प्रमाण सेपरेट फॉर अ तार्किका, इट इज ऑल अंतर्गत इन अनुमान। Still from our perspective we can see arthapatti has been used, anyatha anupapatti has been used, because pratyaksha siddha paraspara vibhago na syat, but is there asti tu, therefore what? That will show that since pratyaksha siddha paraspara vibhaga wouldn't be, but it is there, therefore your samanvaya cannot be, atha pratyakshana samanvaya viruddhyate iti इति चेद इति पूर्वपक्ष। दैट मच इज द ऑब्जेक्शन बाय द पूर्वपक्षी। सिद्धांतस्तु, व्हाट इज सिद्धांत? स्यात् लोकवत्, इन लोक यू हैव सच एग्जांपल्स वेयर प्रतीति ऑफ भेद इज देयर। सो प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध विभाग इज देयर इन द लोक, प्रतीति इज देयर, बट ऐक्य इज नॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज। फॉर एग्जांपल ही सेज एक ब्रह्म उपादानकत्वे अपि भोक्तृभोग्य प्रपंचस्य परस्पर विभाग स्यात् लोकवत्, यथा लोके मृदात्मना अभिन्नानां घटादीनां परस्परं भेदोऽस्ति तद्वत्। एग्जाम्पल यूजेस यथा लोके मृदात्मना अभिन्नानां, इज द पॉट क्ले, यस, इज द बिगर पॉट क्ले, यस, इज द स्मॉलर पॉट क्ले, इज द लेड क्ले, ऑल ऑफ दिस आर क्ले, द गोल्ड बैंगल इज क्ले, द गोल्ड नेकलेस इज सॉरी द गोल्ड बैंगल इज गोल्ड, द गोल्ड नेकलेस इज गोल्ड, द गोल्ड रिंग इज गोल्ड, द गोल्ड इयर रिंग्स आर गोल्ड, सो ऑल ऑफ दिस इज नथिंग बट गोल्ड। सो अभेदा इज देर, अभिन्नानां घटादीनां मृदात्मना अभिन्नानां, सो एज क्ले when you look at the material, is it clay or not? Even in the karya ghata you tap the clay lid, you tap the kumbha, huge pot, all of that is clay. So even if they are non-different as clay, parasparam bheda asti, you cannot say that, oh, I'll buy the big pot at the cost of the small pot, both are clay. You cannot argue that the seller will never sell you the big pot as a at the cost of the small pot, and you will not buy a small pot for the utility of the big pot. If you want to carry 5 liters of water, you cannot have a 1 liter pot as a solution, you cannot buy that. So bhedha asti tadvat, similarly what एक ब्रह्म उपादानकत्वे अपि, ऑल्दो दिस वन ब्रह्म इज उपादान फॉर वेरीगेटेड कार्य जगत भोक्तृभोग्य प्रपंच, द डिविजन ऑफ भोक्ता एंड भोग्य इज देर इन द जगत, प्रतीति इज देर एंड प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध इट इज, आई डू नॉट हैव एनी ऑब्जेक्शन देर सेज द सिद्धांति, बट परस्पर विभाग स्यात्, दैट डिविजन इज देर बट इट कैनॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज ब्रह्मात्मना अभिन्नानां, जस्ट लाइक हियर मृदात्मना अभिन्नानां, यू कैन से एक ब्रह्म उपादानकत्वे अपि कयोः भोक्तृभोग्ययोः, सो बिटवीन भोक्ता एंड भोग्य ऑल्दो देयर एक ब्रह्म उपादान उपादानक मीनिंग दिस इज बहुरी, एकम ब्रह्म उपादानं उपादान कारणं ययोः भोक्तृभोग्ययोः, ते भोक्तृभोग्ये एक ब्रह्म उपादानके, एंड देन तयोः भावः एक ब्रह्म उपादानकत्वम्, एंड तस्मिन् सति एक ब्रह्म उपादानकत्वे सति। सो इवन इफ भोग्य भोक्तृभोग्य प्रपंच हैव वन ब्रह्म एज उपादान, देयरफॉर व्हाट ब्रह्मात्मना भोक्तृभोग्यो अभिन्नत्वमस्ति, इवन देन इवन देन भोक्तृभोग्य प्रपंचस्य अभिन्नत्वम् और भोक्तृभोग्ययोः अभिन्नत्वम् सर्वेषु प्रपंच पदार्थेषु, ऑल्दो देर इज अ भोक्तृभोग्य डिविजन थ्रू एंड थ्रू इन दि लोका, स्टिल ब्रह्मात्मना अभिन्ना दे आर दे ब्रह्म और नॉट दे आर, बट देन जस्ट बिकॉज दे आर ब्रह्म यू डोंट मिक्स देयर भोक्तृत्व एंड भोग्यत्वम्, सो दोज रोल्स आर डेफिनेटली हैविंग द्वैता, वी डोंट हैव एनी विरोध देर, अतः कल्पित भेद सत्वात् न प्रत्यक्ष विरोध इति सिद्धम्। इवन इफ द पूर्व पक्षी कीप्स ऑन आर्ग्यूइंग हाउ कैन यू हैव बोथ, वी से बिकॉज द प्रत्यक्ष सत्ता प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध भेद सत्ता इज कल्पित भेद कल्पित सत्ता कल्पित भेद सत्ता कल्पितानां सत्ता, इट इज नॉट परमार्थ सत्ता, पारमार्थिक सत्ता नास्ति, देयरफॉर व्हाट प्रत्यक्ष विरोध नास्ति, दिस प्रत्यक्ष विरोध समन्वय विरोधे न प्रमाणम, प्रत्यक्ष विरोध इज नॉट गोइंग टू गिव यू ब्रह्म समन्वय विरोध एट ऑल, जस्ट लाइक युअर तर्का इज ऑल्सो नॉट गिविंग एनी समन्वय विरोध, सिमिलरली दिस ऑल्दो देर इज अ विरोध फ्रॉम युअर पर्सपेक्टिव, समन्वय इज नॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज एट ऑल, बिकॉज समन्वय इज सत्य, प्रत्यक्ष भेद इज मिथ्या, तर्क सिद्ध भेद इज ऑल्सो मिथ्या, सो प्रत्यक्ष सिद्ध भेद इज ऑल्सो इक्वली मिथ्या, दैट मिथ्या विरोध इज नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज और कॉम्प्रोमाइज द सत्य समन्वय, सो विल स्टॉप हियर, विल कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट। आम्नायन्ति संसिद्धम् आदि मध्यांतवर्जितम् आनंदघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपासमहे। नमस्ते, धन्यवाद।
नमस्ते।